Welcome to NYU. My name is Maggie Iskander. I'm the chair of the Civil and Urban Engineering Department. Environmental engineering is a growth area for us in terms of numbers of students, number of degrees offered, and number of faculty, and also in terms of facilities. We are in the Environmental Chemistry Lab, which is one of several new labs that are being built at NYU Tandon. A prior generation of environmental engineers have saved more lives than doctors by bringing sanitation to every home in the modern world. Current and future generations of environmental engineers are going to help society adapt to the effects of climate change.
One of the things I'm working on right now is a report about sediment accretion in wetlands versus sea level rise induced by climate change. With some oversight, I have had to walk through the process of starting a research project from scratch and kind of figuring out what my parameters are for that.
Studying environmental engineering partly can be done in the classroom, but also an important part of that will be done in the laboratories. Students will get their hands into sand. They will work with water and wastewater, and they will better understand the behavior of these materials when they, in the real world, they have to actually design and construct treatment systems to address the issues.
Personally, I feel like the lab experiments that we've been going through, I feel are really beneficial because I'm looking into like academia background like after and like going into research. But even if you're planning on going into like consulting, it's really important to have the knowledge of what goes on in the lab when you send the samples out.
I'm actually interested in the water treatment. Being born and raised in New York for my whole life, I heard how New York has one of the best water systems and water treatments. And that sort of caught my eye into taking those courses.
In many of the environmental engineering courses that we teach, we focus on real world problems, thinking about how can we better understand environmental challenges and how can we design solutions to help address some of those challenges.
So my project is related to the photodegradation of pesticides because it's important for us to know if the pesticide will degrade both in the environment and also if we can apply these technologies in water treatment plants.
I'm currently in a class where, well, it's environmental capstone, so we're trying to incorporate both water resources and environmental engineering within it. So we just finished some drainage design. We went through like a lot of like the different forms that we need to go through with like government regulations and stuff like that. And it definitely will prepare me for when I get into the field of work.
This program of ours will also train students in advanced data analytics, giving them the tools they need to work on big problems and particularly to generate policy relevant environmental solutions that go to work with floods and other big data set kinds of problems.
Goal with this program is to arm the students with the tools to come up with creative solutions to continue to live cohesively with the cities, the growing cities, the advancements of our urban centers, and protect the natural resources at the same time.